Okay, in this video I'm going to just rough out this piece of heat-treated chert into a preform with a hammer stone. These are the preforms I've been working with lately. And just to give you an idea of how I rough it out with a hammer stone. Now, I'm not an expert at using a hammer stone. There are guys with videos that do a lot better job at this than I do, but just to give you an idea of what you can do quickly, I'll just rough this out. Now, I'm not sure where the bulb of percussion was on this original piece, but it's probably right here. But you see it's very odd. I have to take away most of this mass here. And it's the same procedure as indirect percussion. Percussion as a whole is very similar in the steps and the process. Strong platforms, try to follow ridges. And with hammer stones on treated rock, you've got to be careful. You can break the whole thing very easily. Now I'm not really following a ridge here, I'm just taking opportunistic flakes to get rid of that mass there. Now this, I can follow a ridge here if I wanted to. Just prepare a little bit better and maybe I can send a flake in that way. And you notice how I'm holding my finger underneath where the flake is supposed to come off. That's just to prevent it from snapping. It also helps the flake to travel a little bit. If I hold it here and then I hit it here, it can snap the point off. But if I'm holding it right where I'm hitting it, it's safer, more stable that way. You don't want to whack too much on the end. And when you do strike, just keep in mind that striking the ends can snap it in half. But right now I don't have a larger amount of mass in the middle than I do on the ends, except for width-wise, which it does help. But from this stage it won't take very long to get it down to the shape of my other preform. And I'm not doing much grinding. In the next video I'll go over grinding a little more in detail. I'm just using a beveling technique to put a platform where I need it, or if I see an existing bevel, like right here. This, I didn't do that, but it's perfect for sending flakes in if I hit it right here. But I don't really don't need to thin that out. I do, however, need to take this off, this ridge, so I can strike here. The platform's a little weak, so strengthen it a little bit. This was sticking out a little bit, it might interfere with the hit, but there we go. So as long as I hit, you know, high enough above the edge, it should be able to take that flake off down that ridge. I missed it, I'm over to the left a little bit, but I can still try. It did hit right on the spot what I wanted, but it didn't hit hard enough. And it hit too far close to the edge, so it didn't take very much off. So just prepare it again. Make sure it's strong. That was a little bit better. See how that took off some of that ridge. And I struck it with the side like this. I didn't strike it with one of these more narrow ends. I just struck it with a fairly flat part of the side so I could hit more of that platform to take a wider flake. And I'm going to hit this right there and try to get rid of some of this mass. And that was just the brushing. All of these strikes so far have been just brushing strikes, hitting those beveled edges, removing fairly thin flakes. And I'll just zigzag this edge in here to make it bifacial. I'm just removing a little more of that mass. And I'll continue to zigzag. I'm getting a lot of steps and crushing here, so I'm going to stop and I might be able to remove that mass from the other side. Cortex absorbs some of the energy, so you may need to hit it harder if you're hitting on the cortex. See, it's just a bevel there that I'm going to strike. Well, I probably needed to strike the other direction. Let's see. Yeah, that one was better. Hit right on the tip, which I don't normally want to do, but it was just, it presented an opportunity and I just hit it and got lucky there. Okay, basically that's it. It's pretty, it's sufficient for the preform. It's a bit larger, but it's fine. I just wanted to demonstrate roughing out with a hammer stone.